Hi, and welcome to this week's episode of the 2-Minute Guru. My name is Daniel Bogdanoff, and today we're going to talk about why you're going to want to know how to use the bandwidth limiting feature on your oscilloscope. Why would you ever want to limit the bandwidth of your oscilloscope? Because you probably paid good money for that bandwidth spec at the top of your scope. Well, there's a couple reasons. The first reason you'd want to limit the bandwidth of your oscilloscope is because you don't need the full bandwidth. And remember, noise is distributed by frequency, so if I can filter out some of those higher bandwidth components of the noise, my signal is going to look cleaner on the scope. The second reason is that you can filter out some deterministic noise. Now, random noise is distributed across the frequency spectrum, but deterministic noise is usually caused by something in the environment. By the way, if you want to know what environmental factors can inject noise into your system, check out last week's video, click the link here. So let's look at an example. I have a 300 millivolt peak-to-peak 10 kilohertz waveform mixed in with an 80 megahertz 30 millivolt peak-to-peak sine wave. So the higher frequency, smaller amplitude waveform that I'm mixing in with my fundamental is essentially representing something in the environment injecting noise onto my sine wave. So now that I have a stable trigger, let's zoom out a little bit and turn on bandwidth limiting. So to turn on bandwidth limiting, I'm gonna select the channel and I'm just gonna turn on the bandwidth limit. And I've now put in a 20 megahertz bandwidth limit on this signal. So I'm still getting 80 megahertz and 30 millivolts peak to peak coming from my function generator acting as noise, but that's all getting filtered out by my, in this case, a 20 megahertz low pass filter on my oscilloscope. So you see that bandwidth limiting can be especially effective if you're looking at lower frequency signals and you don't care either about higher frequency signals, or if you're not looking at something like a square wave, which is gonna have higher frequency components built into it. I'd also be remiss if I didn't mention the amazing blog post by Melissa Spencer over on the Keysight Oscilloscopes blog. The link is below. It talks about a zombie apocalypse. Check it out. It's related to today's video. If this video is helpful, hit the share button below. Tell your friends. Also, be sure to subscribe to the Keysight Oscilloscopes YouTube channel. Like our Facebook page. Hit me up on Twitter. If there's something you want me to cover, put it in the comments below. I read every comment. And thanks for watching. I will see you next week. A quick bonus tip here, you can see how this waveform is kind of doubled up on the screen. That's because it's seen multiple rising edges from the noise on that rising edge, so it's triggering multiple times, even if the signal's actually a falling edge. So to trigger on that better, you can go into mode, coupling in your trigger menu, and adjust your trigger hold off. And I'm at 10 microseconds per division, so I'm just gonna set my hold off for something like 70 microseconds. And now I'm gonna get a stable waveform. Essentially, the hold off tells it after you trigger, wait at least 70 microseconds before you trigger again.